judge has now ruled in the Justina case. Justina Pelletier, she's the little girl in the Massachusetts hospital that has been back and forth, away from her parents. You're not going to believe this in case you haven't heard yet. The judge has ruled for permanent custody to go to the state. Now, how is that even possible? He just a week, 2 weeks ago, said to the DCF that they had to prepare to move her to Tufts and prepare her to move back with her family. 2 weeks later, he says the exact opposite. Something is wrong here. Now, I know there's a lot of people that will say, well, something must be wrong with the family. I was with a good friend of mine and said, Glenn, oh, you know who it was? It was Chris. Chris Balfe, he's the guy who runs the company, and he is not a guy who's really been following this case. He's a guy who's been, you know, following the company and not, you know, necessarily following this case as closely as probably you are or I am. And he said to me yesterday, he said, there's got to be something wrong with his family. It's just this doesn't happen in America. I'm like, Chris, do you listen or watch the network that you are? You're helping me build this network. Are you following this? And I told him last night, and he said, okay, I don't understand that. Because what I told him was, no, the Department of Children and Families in Connecticut have been to this family's house. If this family were so monstrous, they would remove the other daughter who has the same disorder, exactly the same disorder. They would remove that daughter from the house. They would remove the 95-year-old grandmother. There's something wrong here, and it's not with the family. How they have lost their child, and this is, Stu, I need the website where, you know, where you can get the bill passed in your own state from David Barton. You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, let me track that down.
We're in such deep trouble here as a nation where nothing makes sense anymore. Remember when I said you'd not recognize your country? We passed that a long time, but it is really starting to get very, very spooky where they can just take your kid from you now. And in the handbook that you get when you check in all of the writings and everything else from the Boston Children's Hospital, it says if the children that you're checking in, if they become a ward of the state, they can have experimental procedures done on them. What the hell is that? If they're a ward of the state, we can conduct experiments on them? No, I don't think so. Now, nobody else is alleging this, but I don't think that something's wrong here. They are trying to prove that this kid has the disease that she clearly doesn't have because they've treated her now for 15 months and she's getting worse. She clearly doesn't have that.
And there's never been any evidence. They've never said a thing about evidence against the father or the mother.
Well, they say they can't. But yes, you can. You don't have to say it about the child. You can say that about the parents.
Of course they can. You hear that kind of stuff all the time, that children have been removed for abuse. They haven't alleged that.
Matt Staver from the Liberty Council, who is involved because of you and this broadcast, because you started to pass this out on Twitter and Facebook. You started to tell the truth. The Liberty Council down at Liberty University, who, I have to tell you, there are a lot of great universities. There's a lot of great colleges. There's several great universities in my own faith. But I will tell you, one of the best universities I've ever seen is Liberty University. These guys really, they really are amazing. They're really amazing. When I die, if I have anything left, I will be leaving a large sum of money to Liberty University because these guys are truly remarkable. And when it comes to the Supreme Court, when it comes to their, you know, Matt Staver is the head, the president of their law school, and he's been front and center on this pro bono. He's not taking any money from this. He's just doing it because it's right. And he said to me, I've talked to him several times, and he's like, Glenn, honestly, I was the same way that your listeners were for a long time. Okay, there's got to be something wrong here.
Yeah, everybody was.
Yeah, there's got to be something wrong. Wow. He said, the more I look into this case, he said, there is something wrong, and it's with the state of Massachusetts. And he said, I've never seen anything like this before. I think this is connected to the Terri Schiavo. I think this is the next kind of Terri Schiavo case. They're going to kill this girl.
Well, I mean, look how she's deteriorated in a year. A year ago, she could walk. She was ice skating. And none of that's possible for her right now. She just, and didn't they take her to the emergency room last week or the week before for some unknown ailment, and they wouldn't even tell the parents why she was taken to the emergency room?
Yeah, they're not allowed to know.
Yeah.
And the family, they mocked her. We showed the pictures of this last night. She has, stepsis?
I don't know what it's called. Some kind of infection,
it's
right?
It's the infection that you get, you know, if you have a... let's say you have a wound or something, and all of a sudden you start to get the red lines coming up, shows that the poison is moving up from that wound. That's happening. She has a port right on her belly that, you know, evacuates all the food. And so she has this port, and there are red lines coming from that port going up her stomach. Mm. And the family was like, wait a minute, what is this? And the people at the hospital, not the doctors and nurses, but the DCF people, mocked the family. Oh, is it another big problem? Yes, what the hell is that on my daughter? A week later, she's rushed to the hospital, and they won't tell them what happened. We showed those pictures last night on the TV show. If you missed it, you can download it for free. You can just watch it now at theblaze.com/TV.
I guess because they don't have custody. They don't have any right to know.
No, they have no right to know.
About her medical
treatment. They have no right to know. She's going to die in this.
If something's not done.
They have killed and misplaced children in Massachusetts several times. In fact, before the show is over, could you get Matt Staber on? Because the number of children that are missing or dead in Massachusetts through DCF is astounding. And it's not just this case.
Really? Okay. And it's not just the five we've heard about?
Oh, no.
Up until this point?
Oh, no, no.
Really?
Oh, no. Liberty Counsel is on this. There is a real problem with DCF. A real deep problem with DCF.
What does he think is going on?
He doesn't know. But that's why he's now saying, look, this is, they're playing. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what's going on. But I'm begging you to pray on this. Tomorrow, I'm going to be down in Philadelphia at the Philadelphia Union Club, and I'm going to be speaking there for the Terri Schiavo Foundation, and that's all about life. And I'm telling you, we have got to start protecting life. I've never been an abortion guy. Pat and I have talked about this for years. You know, geez, we've got enough things we're carrying on our back. And then the abortion people have been like, hello, is there anything bigger? And we're like, hello, we can't carry any more water. But I have to tell you, we decided, 2 years ago or so? We just can't be silent, because that is one of the big roots. One of the big roots of the problem of our society is we just don't value life. And if you don't value life, you're going to be in real trouble. And we used to say that, you know, well, that's a slippery slope and it's going a long way and you've got to... No. Look at what's happening in the socialist country of Great Britain. In the socialist country of England, they are now literally burning babies for heat in their hospitals. Now, I know that sounds outrageous and crazy and
aborted babies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Aborted babies.
Yeah.
Miscarried babies.
Right.
Babies.
Yes.
Key word.
Not live born, hopefully. I mean, at this point.
I don't know. I don't know what their conditions are. Do they have the thing where they were born and then you could kill them? You could just put them in what Barack Obama said. Voted for, stood up for.
And it would actually be technically more green to burn a live baby, because then you're ending a life too. So
I mean, it's
gonna get there.
This is so horrific. It doesn't even sound real.
No,
it doesn't sound real. It sounds like, come on, guys.
Mm-hmm.
They would never do that. Yes, they are.
And they admitted it, by the way. That's not us saying they're doing it. They admitted doing it.
Now, here's the thing. Now in England, they're trying to pass a law. Think of this. They're trying to pass a law that says you can't burn babies for fuel.
that wasn't a law before in Great Britain? Because I...
Wasn't a law? You don't need a law. Shouldn't you all know? Shouldn't we all know? I'm dead serious. Shouldn't we all know? You don't do that.
We should.
Is there not somebody with the shovel or the pitchfork or however they're doing it? Was there not somebody going, I can't do this, man. This is wrong. How long was this going on before somebody said, this is wrong?
But I would argue that the baby is more offended by the killing of it than it is the burning after death. So why, if you approve the first process, why wouldn't you approve the second process?
But it is a sign of showing that
to callousness.
It's a baby. And so, I mean, it shows two things. One, if you're outraged by that, then stop calling it a fetus. It's a baby. If you're outraged by that, it's because you know it's a baby. If you're not outraged by that, it shows the level of your depravity. It shows you how far you've gone. Someday they will show pictures of somebody in the basements shoveling the babies into the ovens, and we will recognize that was a Holocaust. But right now, we turn away from it. And we don't look. But someday, and I'm telling you, do not be on that side. I read something last night. Listen to this. They have built the high places of Baal to burn their children in the fire as offerings. Mm. I'll make them fall by the sword before their enemies, at the hands of those who want to kill them. I'll give their carcasses as food to birds and animals. I'll devastate their cities and make it an object of horror and scorn. That's Jeremiah.
And what's the first part of that again?
They have built the high places of Baal. Now, Baal was the god of the earth.
Mm-hmm.
Baal was the god of weather.
Environment.
The environment, mm-hmm, of weather, mm-hmm, of finance. He's the god of Al Gore. He's the god of Barack Obama. Everything that they believe would have been covered by the god of Baal. They have built the high places of Baal to burn their children in the fire as offerings to Baal. What are they doing? This is one of the ways the hospital says it can remain green. If that's not burning the children in an offering to Baal, I don't know what is. I mean, here's another thing. We don't talk about the scriptures on the air. We never have talked about scriptures on the air, ever. I said to my staff in 2002 or 2003, when I start talking about the Bible on the air, look out, because we're in trouble. When I start actually saying the word Jesus or the Lord or anything like that, look out, because we're in real trouble. I am now saying, open up your Bibles to Jeremiah 19:5, because that's the story of the day. I don't do this because I think it's going to be popular, but there's no way this is going to be popular. There's no way this should be said. This needs to be said.
Believe me, we'd rather do more on trivia.
My gosh, I'd love to screw off.
Mm-hmm.
I'd love to screw off. The last thing I want to say is, and he'll devastate the city, make it an object of horror and scorn, and give their carcasses as food to the birds and animals. Good morning, everybody. Wah, wah. I mean... And I know you feel exactly the same way, but I don't want to, I'm not trying to scare you, because I know, look, if you're listening to this show, you're either being paid by George Soros, or you've been here, you know what's going on. So I'm not telling you, I'm just saying, my job is to warn, my job is to point to the signposts. I'm there to say, here's your mile marker, you're getting closer, here's your mile marker. I really, truly believe that is my job. To see over the horizon, to see what are possible if you don't get off the highways, to show the mile markers of where you are, and quite honestly, to build a framework of hope, and to be able to, if I may quote Walt Disney, to build a beacon that will provide hope and courage to the rest of the world. Now, I don't think that necessarily... telling you what I found from Jeremiah is actually going to be a beacon of hope and courage, but we have frank conversations here, and it's scary, but it's time to have those frank conversations. I want you to go to parentalrights.org. That's how you can find this bill, where you can help them pass a help them pass this bill, and I'll explain it to you. But it is about parental rights, and it stops things like the Justina case from happening to you or your children. It needs to be passed in all 50 states. It's already been passed in, I think, 8 states. It needs to be passed in yours. Go to parentalrights.org and find out all about it.